What up, what up, what up? No, it's not ET. It's your girl, Yolanda Moore, and I'm back with another edition of Straight From The Coach's Mouth. Listen, I just wanna say thank you to all of you who responded to the video. I read all of the comments, I read all the inbox messages, and even got some text messages. And a lot of you seem to connect with my story, more so the injuries than anything. I got a lot of questions about what that process was like, you know, mentally, emotionally, and physically. And I'm gonna share with you in the next few episodes the process that I went through to get off the crutches and back on the court.
He told the guy, he said, when you want to succeed as bad as you want to be, then you'll be successful.
There is no shortcut to success. No matter the cost, no matter the obstacle, no matter the challenge, that you are gonna do whatever it takes, you can have whatever it is that you decide that you want if you're willing to do the work. I remember sitting in the doctor's office after we'd gotten the results of the MRI, and I really didn't know what to expect because I had never been injured before. Going into the doctor's office, I was scared. I was nervous because I just didn't know what was going to happen. The results of the MRI was a torn meniscus. I had no idea what that meant. But then he told me something else. He said that I had bad arthritis in my knees and that I had the knees of an 80-year-old woman, and that if I continued to play basketball by the time I was 30, that I probably wouldn't even be able to walk or I would need total knee replacement. Like in my mind, I'm thinking it's over. You know, I was like I said, I was an All-American. I was the one. Like, I was used to being a superstar. I was used to playing at a very, very high level. He said your recovery process and how strong you come back and even the time frame would absolutely depend on the amount of work that I was willing to put in. He told me that it was gonna be more mental than anything, but that if I was willing to put in the work and go through it, then I could come back just as strong as I was before. I want you to stop right now. We're not even talking about sports. Like, this has nothing to do with basketball right now. You may be in a situation where you have to make a decision where you're facing something that's detrimental, like a loss of a job or a health issue or even a loss of a marriage or relationship or something, and it's something that could really change the trajectory of your life. You know, right now, whatever it is that you're facing, you have the power. Like, you have the power to decide how it turns out. There were three things that I needed to do in order for me to get back on that court and get back to my career and get back to my future. And those same three things are what I need for you to do to get from where you find yourself now, like where you are right now, to where it is that you know you need to be. The first thing is I had to accept the fact that I was injured. It was nothing I could do about it. There was no point in me crying about it. It wasn't gonna change the situation. So I need you to accept the fact that where you are is where you are. You have to accept the fact that it is what it is. People were asking me, you know, like, what happened? What happened? And I kept having to relive that moment, but I had to just stop talking about it because it was over. And you've got to accept where you are right now, regardless of how you got there. And the reason that it's so important that you accept where you are right now is because you got to kill the noise. You just got to kill the noise because the noise is killing you. You got to stop talking to your friends. You got to stop talking to your parents. You got to stop talking to yourself. It's killing you. You can't move forward if you keep rehearsing the past. Listen, I'm not telling you something that I myself haven't gone through. It's not something I heard, ain't nothing I read in a book. This is what I went through. This is what I've experienced. And I'm telling you that if I can go through it and get through it, then you can go through it and get through it too. Let your dreams be more important than any situation that you have going on right now. This is Yolanda, and you heard it straight from the coach's mouth.